I love that song so much. It's so awesome. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Gal. I hope you guys enjoyed that opening sequence as much as I did. In this video, I'm showing you guys an awesome new pack that I love. It's called Hand Painted Titles. It's a motion graphics title pack that you can just drag and drop in Premiere. It's freaking awesome. It's fast, it's easy to use. These guys that made the pack, they spent 500 hours making inside of After Effects to make it simple and easy to use in Premiere in just seconds. So I'm gonna show you how I overlaid all that awesome text in the opening sequence with elements. And then at the end of the video, I'm also gonna show you how you can use some of the elements just for your general videos, like arrows pointing down for like a YouTube video for a link in the description. Or let's say you need to have social media icons pop up. I'll show you guys how you can do that as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump in. All right, you guys, I'm inside of Premiere Pro CC 2019, and this is my final sequence where I've stacked all of these little popping elements as well as the hand-painted titles on top of each other. And what I'm going to do is start from scratch and show you how I built some of these elements, not all of them, but some of them that'll get you started in your own video. So let's go ahead and go to this other sequence here where I don't have any of the elements or the titles on screen. I really want to show you this one here because this was a music lyrical video. I actually had some of the elements move to the beat of the music. So at this moment, I chose to have two sparks appear to the beat. So if I play this back, you can listen. So those dun dun, that's where I want to add some sparks. So where are these elements? Where are the titles? Where do you import them? So I'm in the graphics workspace, and this is where we're going to use the essential graphics panel. So if you go to browse, I've already imported them and they're called hand painted. But if you haven't imported them yet, what you can do is go down to the lower right corner, click on it to install a motion graphics template. And here you can choose which version for the version of Premiere that you're working with. So if you're working in 2017, not 2019 yet, you can use the Google Fonts 4K or the HD version. Now what I used was I used the Any Font here for 2019 because with the new release, you can now use any font in a mogrt, which is fantastic. And because I work in HD, I've already imported the hand elements too and just the hand elements pack as well as Any Font HD. So if I wanted to install Any Font 4K, I would just hit open. So let's go ahead and search for hand painted here inside of Essential Graphics, and you can see all of them here. If Smashworks releases any new versions of this hand painted pack after you've already purchased it, no worries, they will send you the update right away. So let's go ahead and get started with the elements. So I'm gonna use the hand painted elements HD, just going to drag and drop it in here, and it loads on up. So here you have all of them. If you want to just choose one, this is when you use your slider. So you can kind of go through all the different elements like so. For this first one, I used the spark element, which is element number 9. You can also just type it in like so. So this is the element I used here for that beat. So let's go ahead and find where we should place that. So right about here, we want that to go. So I'm just gonna move that over. Looking good. Now here, I'm just gonna change this color to white, like so, and then also move this over into the upper left corner here, like so. So you can use these parameters to rotate, scale, or move the position. Now there's a second beat. So right here, I want another element to come up. So I'm gonna duplicate this by holding the Alt or the Option key on your keyboard, clicking and then releasing. And then I'm just gonna move this over to meet the playhead. And here I want this to be on the right hand side. And I'm just gonna lower that down. Now let's see how that looks. All right, that's looking pretty good. So now let's move on to another section with the lyrics so I can show you how to use the titles. Let's go back to browse. So here I'm going to use Any Font HD because my sequence is in the HD format, and I'm just gonna drag and drop this down. And it'll just take a second to cache and then it will load on up. And here, what we're going to do is the lyrics. So it's, I've been coming alive. And it will update. And then we can choose any font that we want. Remember, only in the 2019 version can you update to any font that you like. So I highly recommend updating to 2019 if you haven't yet. So the particular font that I used was called Claudia with a K. And let's go ahead and update that. And let's make this font just a bit bigger. I think that looks good. And then let's change the color to white. And let's go ahead and bring this down like so. Now this is where you can actually choose if you want it to render faster. You can actually move the texture details under text details. You can move this over and you can see that all of the texture has gone away. Let me zoom in so you can see this better. So one is fast render, meaning you can, you know, move through your timeline with ease and you're not going to have any delay. But then as you want to add texture after you're done with, you know, making the style of the text how you want, you can move this to two. And you can see now it's in a bristle brush type of look. And you can make sure that paint bleed is checked because it gives it more of a rough look and I really like that. Or you can try wet paint number three, and that's what the wet paint looks like. Or you can choose four, which is the wood stamp. So let's just go ahead and keep it with that. Let me zoom back out here again, and this is what it looks like. Now, how did I get it to animate on screen? Well, I actually just used a built-in effect called wipe and just dragged and drop it on top. And then I extended it out and I just played it back until it matched the lyric duration. So it's a little bit too slow, so I'm just gonna move that back a little bit. That works pretty good. So that's what I did for the first one, and then it repeats again. So right here, she starts to repeat. Let's roll this edit back because we want it to end at this playhead. And now I'm just gonna hit Alt Option, click, hold, release to duplicate that and just bring it on over. So it's a repetition. So that was a bit slow, so we need to move this over to the left a bit. And then here she starts to say again. So I'm just gonna use the arrow key to move over and then roll this edit back. Click on this clip, Alt Option key, drag and drop to duplicate. Let's click on the wipe, hit delete to get rid of that. And then here I'm just gonna write again. Now you can use the effect controls up here to move this up. Sometimes I find that that's easier to use. It's more clean and smooth. So I'm just gonna bring this up a bit here like so, using the effect controls. Here I'm actually gonna add an element on top of this. It's a circle element. And this is where I'm gonna go back and just go grab this little spark. I'm gonna Alt Option, click, drag and release to have this pop appear over here. But instead of the element number 9, I'm going to use element 22. And this is just a circular pop here. So you can see it kind of gets bigger like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to move this over like so. And I'm gonna move this to the beginning of the clip. And then I'm gonna bring this down so it's right in the center. And then I also added another little fun squiggly little element. It is element number 7. I'm gonna Alt Option key, select it, drag it up to duplicate, and then I'm going to go to element number 7, and I'm going to just move this up a bit here. And now this kind of just kind of nicely floats across the screen, which is pretty cool. And then I want to show you guys how to do social media elements using fonts. So once again, let's Alt Option key, select this text layer, drag it over. And now let's delete. Now let's zoom in here and let's delete this wipe. Now here is where we're going to use a font that displays text as social icons. Now I downloaded this font. It's called fontdiner.com sparkly. It's free from defont.com, and you can see that it will turn my text into social icons. So this is where we have to go in and actually click on the keyboard and find the right key for that social icon. So T I discovered was Twitter, and then Y I discovered was YouTube, and F is Facebook, and C is Instagram. So when you click out, it'll display all those icons. And here we can actually change the size, and then we can move this over. So let's go to the right a bit, too far, and then up, just like that. And if you wanted to have a call to action on top, once again, Alt Option, select, bring up, drop, and now it's duplicated. And here we just want to change this to be Claudia again, or whatever font you want to use. And then we can change this to Follow Me. And now all we have to do is bring this up just a bit. And I want to have the line wiggle happening on both of these, so I'm just going to select that and turn those on. And now let's go ahead and let's hit Command S to save our project. Saving is important. And then let's go ahead and render it out by hitting the return or enter key on your keyboard. All right, now let's just quickly go through and show you how it looks. All right, there's those elements, and then here is the lyrical part. And then here's the social media. You guys enjoyed that opening sequence as much as I. So you can see, you can just stack, play around with these. I haven't done all of the elements, but you can see how many elements I duplicated to build that lyrical sequence in the beginning. There's probably like about 50 elements here. So have fun, stack away, duplicate, customize, have fun with this hand-painted pack. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did. I love this hand-painted pack. If you guys want to get it for yourself, I'll put a link at the top of my description box just below here. If you guys need any other priority support, urgent questions, or any mentorship opportunities like one-on-one trainings, head on over to my Patreon community, patreon.com/premieregal, and join as a patron. And I look forward to seeing you guys there. That's it for this video. Let's go ahead and enjoy this musical outro. See you guys next time. Bye. Living out of touch, but now feeling like I'm born again.